The massacre in Mumbai. Indian authorities say the lone gunman who survived was trained by a Pakistani militant group with suspected links to this Islamist institution just outside Lahore, Pakistan. The institution's response? A public denial. And an invitation to a group of reporters to show this is no terrorist training camp.
This is only an educational and residential complex. Nothing else is here. You are allowed to visit independently or follow me. It's up to you.
This is the property of Jamaat-ud-Dawah, an organization that claims to offer services, education, and the true teachings of Islam. Indian and U.S. officials call it a front for Lashkar-e-Taiba, a banned Pakistani militant group fighting against Indian rule in the disputed region of Kashmir. In 2001, Lashkar was accused in the attack on the Indian parliament. In 2006, it was blamed for bombing railway stations in Mumbai. And now Indian authorities say the gunman they have in custody says he was trained by Lashkar. Jamaat-ud-Dawah acknowledges past ties to Lashkar, but insists they were severed in 2002 when, under pressure from Washington, Pakistan banned the group.
Jamaat-ud-Dawah is only in Pakistan and doing humanitarian and relief activities.
During the tour, reporters were free to roam the 75-acre campus and visit classrooms where Jamaat-ud-Dawah says more than 800 students study Islam, math, and science courses for a monthly tuition of roughly $30.
Everyone can get the admission in this institution.
Jamaat-ud-Dawah denied any involvement in the Mumbai attacks, but didn't hide its feelings about India.
We speak loudly, and we let the general public know that this is the India is the enemy. So the India thinks that this is the voice, it should be silent.
Among the men the Indian government has demanded Pakistan turn over is the founder of Jamaat-ud-Dawah. If that happens, analysts say expect repercussions, since Jamaat-ud-Dawah is a respected institution among many Pakistanis. Reza Sayah, CNN, Islamabad.